Watch. Ben Affleck doesn't care about other people's opinions. Less than a week before his death, Bob Saget opened up about previously testing positive for COVID-19. It's unclear when he had the disease, though it seems he was not battling it at the time of his death because he performed a comedy show in Florida the day prior. No cause of death has been given for the comedian, who passed away at age 65 in his hotel room in Orlando, Florida, on January 9. Authorities said they found no signs of foul play or drug use. Saget spoke on the January 5 episode of the iHeartRadio podcast A Corporate Time with Tom. Shared that had tested positive before, but didn't say when. It is not good. It does not feel good. I had it, he said. I don't know if I had Delta or I might have had a combo. They might have been working together. Saget then joked, I think at one point Omicron was opening for Delta, but Omicron got too big, Delta is opening now for Omicron. It wasn't the first time the Full House star has discussed the coronavirus pandemic. In November, he tweeted, I went to the dumbest pharmacist yesterday and asked for my booster and he gave me a child seat, and joked, I was pissed. Until I sat at the table and was a foot taller. On the deck, 13 episode of Bob Saget's Here For You, he made another comment about having received the booster shot recently. Be careful out there. Do whatever you gotta do to be safe. I try not to preach you know about it, he began. I got my booster shot, I am 65, so I got it yesterday, day before, and I was. He seemingly made another joke, saying, I've been telling people I got it in my ass but I had it right below my balls because I wanted them to get bigger. Saget shared a photo of a COVID-19 test on December 22, covering up the results with a handwritten tic-tac-toe game. He quipped, I don't know what to make of this. Has anybody else gotten this kind of test results? Less than 3 weeks later, Saget gave his final comedy show at the Ponte Vedra Concert Hall in Ponte Vedra Beach, Florida. An attendee told E! News he absolutely rocked the house at the January 8th show. The comic later tweeted, loved tonight's show. Appreciative audience, adding, I had no idea I did a two-hour set tonight. I am happily addicted again to this tea. The next day, the Orange County Sheriff's Office responded to a man down call around 4 p.m. at the Ritz-Carlton Orlando, per a statement to E! News. On arrival, they located a man who was unresponsive in a hotel room, police said. The man, identified as Robert Lane Saget, was pronounced deceased on scene. We have no information on cause of death. Authorities noted that the medical examiner's office will determine his cause and manner of death at a later time. His wife of 3 years, Kelly Rizzo, spoke out on Monday, January 10, about his sudden passing. My whole heart. Bob was my absolute everything, she said in a statement to E! News. I am so completely shattered and in disbelief. I am so deeply touched by the outpouring of love and tribute from our friends, family, his fans and his peers. Rizzo noted, when the time is right and when this news is not as raw, I look forward to sharing more of Bob with the world.